Hey guys, I'm Adrian. So I wanted to share my experience on how I've nearly given up on life when I was younger. So during secondary school life, I had a lot of problems with my family, my education. So it was a mess, it was a big mess. And I was lucky that I had three good friends who were always there for me. So what I'm trying to say is, no matter what happens, people who are around you, they always care for you. So don't give up. Always think of your loved ones. Like the saying goes, keep living and keep learning.
Hi guys, my name is Leon and welcome to this event. Let me tell you something that is something very close to my heart. And you know, the one thing that I appreciate most, the person closest to me, is my mom. And I tell you, I wouldn't be here if it weren't for her. So I thank her very much. You see, she told me a story once. Once I suffered from eczema and extreme asthma, and I was facing death. And because of my mom and also my dad, the both of them stayed by my side every night without leaving me. And the best thing is that their tears every day. And it's my parents, you know, every day they sacrifice for me because of my sickness. It wasn't easy bringing me up, according to them. It was hard. Even now, you know, they do so much for me. It's not about the things that they buy, it's about how much they sacrifice, the pain that I went through, even they went through. Like, quickly, I say, like, the story, you know, some people, you know, when you meet babies, touch them, you know, give them sweets. My mom and my dad would instantly scold people and say, don't give them anything. And then people will say, why are you so fussy with your child? But other people do not understand that I was going through. So my message to everyone is, appreciate your parents very much, especially, you know, when you're going through this. And always remember in your life, your friends, your family, always remember to keep living and keep loving.
Hey guys, my name is Riley. Welcome to Keep Living, Keep Loving Musical Dance Drama 2013. I just want to share with you guys about a true story of mine. When in secondary school, I had a friend who committed suicide. He jumped off from a shopping complex because he owed people 20,000 bucks. I was stunned at that when people told me about his time, because the day before, I just say hi to him. The very next day, he's dead. So, people, life is so fragile, it had no tattoo. So, we all should keep living and keep loving. I appreciate your life.
Hi, welcome to NDD. And my name is Kieran, and I just want to share to you a personal experience of mine, a testimony of my own life. As a kid, I was growing up learning about the things in this world, about what love is, about what moral values are. And the thing is, everyone have their own perspective. And for me, what I saw in my life, in my family, in the people around me, I saw a lot of hate, that I felt like I was always being rejected. I was always being picked on. I was always being hurt. And as I grew up, I just grew up with all this hate in my heart. And I was a really, really angry kid. But As I grew to be the person I am today, I find it very different. Why? Simply because at one point, being so angry, you start to hear words of hope, you start to hear words of peace, you start to hear words that are comforting and caring. And for me, the things that I heard of were things like, for I know the thoughts I have for you, says the Lord. Thoughts for peace, not for evil. Thoughts for you to have a future and to have a hope. And that's Jeremiah 29:11. And for me, I found refuge in God. And that's what really helped me to move out of my issues, to actually start pruning the garden in my heart, to take out the thorns and start doing my gardening. And the thing is, all that really helped in a way that today, who I am is completely different. The relationships I have with the people around me, it's amazing. how, for me, I used to be someone who hated people so close, even family. But today, it's really, really different that you can see me and my brother. If you would ask him, if you have a chance to ask him, you know, it'll be really amazing the stories he'll tell you of how we hated each other so much, but today we just love each other so much. And despite all the struggles that we still go through in family, in among friends, I always look to see the hope. I always get the hope. I always have hope in the people around me. Yeah, and the peace to carry on, knowing that there are people who love me and I love them too. So that's just my message for you to, you know, don't be afraid of clearing up the thorns in your heart, the issues that are there, and start to love the people that are already around you. Because there's no point throwing the people away when you can actually throw the issues away. So keep living and keep loving.